Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. In this session, we are going to discuss further about the Unit 2, States of Matter and Properties of Matter. And in this session, we are going to discuss about the relative humidity and about the liquid complexes and liquid crystals. So what is humidity? The very first question which arises in our mind is, what is humidity? So humidity is basically the amount of the water vapor which is present in the air at a specific temperature. So normally, what is the amount of the water vapor? It varies with the temperature and they are the inversely proportional. So like at any specific temperature, the air can hold a certain amount of the water vapor. Now, then the relative humidity, as the term specifies relative, it simply means percentage, comparison. So the amount of the water vapor which is actually present in the air compared to the maximum amount of the water vapor that air can hold at that specific temperature is known as relative humidity. So now the both the terms are clear. Humidity, the presence of the specific amount of the water vapor at any time point at a specific temperature, and relative humidity, the maximum amount of the water vapor which air can hold and the actual amount of the water vapor which is being present in the air. So it is expressed as a percentage, relative. So at 100% relative humidity, air is known as saturated. It simply means that no more water vapor can be added up and the air is saturated. It can hold the maximum amount of the water vapor. Now let us try to understand the comparison of the relative humidity as compared to the temperature. So as the temperature increases, it simply means the rate of evaporation increases. So when the rate of evaporation increases, it causes a decrease in the humidity. So there are less amount of water vapor present in the, because the it is getting converted into the gaseous state. So they are inversely proportional. So at lower temperature, the relative humidity rises, and at a higher temperature, the relative humidity decreases. So you have to remember it as a thumb rule that humidity is inversely proportional to the temperature. So humidity is normally measured using the hygrometers. You must have done this experiment about the wet bulb and the dry bulb measurements in the lab. So in the wet bulb, you must have used the cotton which is being soaked in water, and then you have measured it. So like these are the two techniques which are widely used in the labs for the measurement of the relative humidity using the wet and dry hygrometers. Next, we move on to the liquid complexes. Like in my previous session, I discussed about the different states of the matter. As per the modern classification, there are basically the 12 states of the matter. But broadly, when we classify them, we have classified into three categories, that is solid, liquid and gas. But when one phase changes into another, this change does not happen abruptly. This is a very slow phase transition. So when one phase changes into another phase, it slowly changes, and the intermittent stages have also their own property, their own set of the properties. So when a solid changes into the liquid state, this change of state is a very slow state. This transition is very slow, and the intermittent stage, intermittent means the in between stage of the solid and the liquid transition, is referred to as the liquid crystals. So like you can see in the image also, you have the solid which is in the crystalline form. It has a very particular specific orientation. So like they have the ideal 3D structures and they are specifically placed. But in the liquid, you can see there is the disorientation. So the intermittent stage, where you don't have that complete disorientation and you are still able to maintain that crystalline structure. So this crystalline structure is altered since it is not complete solid, it is not complete liquid. This is the intermittent stage, and this stage is referred to as liquid crystals. So basically they are the complex mixtures, and they are the coexistent. Two stages are actually reflecting in this stage. It is partially solid, partially liquid, and the state is known as liquid crystals. So it can happen with the solid liquid, for example, suspensions or the solutions of macromolecules such as polymers, or with the solid gas transition, intermittent stage of solid gas transition. For example, partially solid, partially gas. We know this state as a granular state, or it can be in the form of the liquid and gas. For example, a state in which the substance is partially into the liquid form and partially into the gas form. You must have seen the liquid foams. You must have used the liquid shampoos, liquid foam shampoos. So when we see the foam, it is partially liquid and partially into the gaseous forms, because since the term is foam, so it has the properties of both liquid and foam or the gas. Or similarly, you must have seen for the emulsions. Emulsions are liquid and liquid mixtures, and they have the properties of both liquid. So these intermittent stages which coexist while the transition is taking place from one phase to another exhibits unusual mechanical responses. Since they are not they are having the mixture, they are having the mixed property, so they are neither solid nor liquid, so they exhibit different reactions, different mechanical responses to applied stress or the strain. So when we apply pressure, we observe that it is not behaving like a solid, it is not behaving also like a liquid, but it is having totally different behavior. Now this is due to the change in the geometrical construction of these liquid crystals. You can see solids have an ideal crystalline structures. Liquids have a different molecular structures. The molecules in liquids are far apart from each other. So in these intermittent crystals, when their phase transition is going around, has the properties of both solid and liquid. So you can say the molecular arrangement is totally different from both of them, and therefore the response is also different. These in the mechanical responses, which includes the transitions between solid like and fluid like behavior, as well as various fluctuations are being observed. So their mechanical properties can be attributed to characteristics such as their highly ordered arrangement, which has been disordered, and caging and clustering on multiple length scales. So my dear students, you must understand, since this is the intermittent stage, so it has the attributed properties from both the states, from the solid as well as the liquid state. It has a different unusual reactions with the when any form of the mechanical stress is being applied to them. So they their molecular arrangement is disordered, and they have different caging structures. So various preparations, like commercially used preparations like liquid gas foams, you have seen in the shampoos all as well as in the shaving creams. So you can see these intermittent stages are also used in various formulation development as well, that we are going to discuss. The classic example is of shaving cream. So shaving cream is basically an example of a complex fluid. How it is complex fluid? Because it is neither solid, it is neither liquid, nor it is gas. So it is the intermittent stage between liquid and the gas. So without the stress, the foam appears to be a solid. It does not flow and can support very light load. So it can bear the pressure. It is into the solid state. However, when adequate stress is being applied, shaving cream flows like a liquid fluid. So it behaves like a liquid. So this is the intermittent stage between solid and the liquid. So on the level of the individual bubbles, the flow is due to the rearrangements of the small collections of the bubbles. So there is rearrangements of the small collections of the bubbles, and the flow therefore is not smooth, but instead constant of the fluctuations due to rearrangements of the bubbles and the release of the stress. So when you press and then you stop and then you press again, so this due to this variation in the stress movements, you can observe the inconsistencies in the flow as well. So this is just an example of an solid and liquid transition which has been commercially utilized, and there are several examples of these intermittent stages which are utilized in the formulation development. For example, in the aerosols also, it is the transition state for the liquid and gaseous mixtures, and like there are several other preparations. So when the transition between one phase to another phase takes place, these intermittent stage have the advantage that they have the properties of both the phases, and this property they have their unusual mechanical strength and unique properties. Now these unique properties can be utilized in the development of the dosage forms. Next, you can see in this image the characteristics liquid crystals. So when the phase transitions takes place, these intermittent stages have these crystal structures, and they have been observed under the microscope. So basically the liquid crystals have again been classified into three types. So the first is the solid phase, second is the liquid phase, and third is the gaseous phase. So when we talk about the solid phase, as the term indicates, solid phase, the molecules in the solid phase of the liquid crystals have better orientation and positional order. So you can see, like the crystalline forms we discussed, the arrangement is quite ordered, and they have a specific peculiar arrangement. The molecules are very close to each other and their bonding is very tight as compared to the liquid phase. Now, liquid phase is intermittent stage in terms of the molecular arrangement. So it is like having weak forces of the attraction, and the molecules don't have no orientations and they don't have position that positional orders, but they are actually held together by the weak intermolecular forces. Now, the gas phase, you must have seen in my earlier videos also, I have shared the classic differences between solid phase, liquid phase and the gas phase. So in the gas phase, the molecules are very far apart from each other and they don't have that intermolecular forces of attraction, which is very strong in the case of solid phase and weak in the case of the liquid phase. Next, we are going to study about the liquid crystals classifications. The image you are seeing over here, apart from the classification, you can see this is how the liquid crystals looks like under the microscope. So again, since this is a transition phase, you can see the different flows, and these flows are actually representing different colors. So like when we talk about the classification in details, you have to memorize this classification. Like, liquid crystals are broadly classified into two types based on their behavior towards the temperature. The first is the thermotropic and second is the lyotropic. So when we classify them on the basis of thermotropic, again they can be classified like rod-like structures and second disc-like structures. So rod-like structures are further classified into pneumatic and the somatic. So you can see the clear-cut division in the molecular arrangement of the pneumatic and the somatic type, and the disc-like structures like the column arrangement. You can see there are layers of these columns. So by these image representations, you can actually, you don't have to memorize the classification, you simply memorize the structure, you recall the structure. So pneumatic, you can see the overlapping arrangement is there in the somatic. It is again highly organized like a crystalline structure. So somatic is more similar to your crystalline structure. So pneumatic, little disordered, overlapped structure, somatic, highly ordered structure, and disc-like structures like column. Then when we talk about the lyotropic sort of the classification, again it is divided into three types. The first is the lamellar, hexagonal and the cubic. This you can easily memorize by seeing the shapes. Like, cubic have the specific cubic shape, second hexagonal shape, and third is a lamellar. You must have seen the structure of the skin. So like it is having that lamellar structure, you can memorize it. So liquid crystals are classified into two types: thermotropic, lyotropic. Thermotropic further into two types: rod-like, disc-like, depending what kind of the molecules they do have. Disc-like is classified as columnar, and rod-like into pneumatic and somatic. Then lyotropic again into the lamellar, hexagonal and the cubic. So depending on the type of the molecular shape and their orientation, they have been classified into different categories. Now again, this is the example for your isotropic and anisotropic characteristics. Anisotropic basically refers to the crystalline properties, and isotropic refers to the amorphous properties. So like anisotropic, here you can see the molecular arrangement is highly ordered and it is having that specific orientation. So liquid crystals have orientational orders, whereas when we talk about the isotropic crystals, the liquids and the gases have uniform properties in all the directions. So you can see anisotropic is basically referring to the solid liquid crystals having the orientational orders, and isotropic referring to the liquid and gaseous types. Because in my previous slide, I have clearly mentioned that liquid crystals are further classified into solid crystals, liquid crystals and gaseous crystals. Next, about the liquid crystals. Liquid crystals are further classified on the basis of pneumatic, somatic and cholesteric phase. So like, as we increase the opacity, then first is the pneumatic phase, then comes the somatic phase, and third cholesteric phase depending on the opacity. So like here is also one diagram where you can see that among the solid or the crystalline, which is also referred to as the anisotropic form, it is getting converted to the isotropic liquid and through the liquid crystalline phase. So you can see there is slight disorientation first and then it is completely disoriented. So you can see basically what happens is that when any substance changes from the solid or crystalline solid phase structure structure to the liquid phase structure, also known as the isotropic liquid, it gets converted through a intermittent stage, which is liquid crystalline. So basically what happens is that molecular structure breaks down. Now it does not break down completely immediately, but there is a slow transition of this breakdown. So first they get this organized, and then they are being the structure is actually getting disordered. So the intermittent stage have the properties of the both solid crystalline structure and the isotropic fluid, because fluidity has started. So they have the unique properties attributed. In the below diagram also you can see the solution is getting converted to crystals on cooling down. So when the solution is being cooled out, the intermittent stage is the liquid crystalline. You can see a beautiful color, the color type of that jar, and this beautiful color is due to the intermittent stage before actually being converted down into the crystals. So this stage is known as the liquid crystals. I hope you have got a better idea about the liquid crystals now. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel Pharmacypedia for getting further updates. Thank you so much.